Hello, everyone. I hope you're all having a good week. Today, I want to talk to you about something I've always found really, really interesting. I want to talk to you about how airplanes fly. I've always wondered how something that big and heavy can get up into the air and fly so high. So it's because of something called Bernoulli's principle. Now, Daniel Bernoulli was a scientist who worked in the 1700s. He started out as a doctor, but what he really loved was mathematics. So he switched fields. And he studied in Italy and in Russia and in Switzerland, and he learned all of these wonderful things. And he figured out all sorts of interesting things about how fluids work when they are in motion. And it's a field now that we call fluid dynamics. And it tells us all sorts of interesting things like how waves work and how the air in the atmosphere moves around and how air pressure works and all sorts of things like that. But understanding how air pressure works was really important because it helped later engineers and scientists figure out how to build an airplane that would fly. So I have a model plane here that I want to show you. Now, you can see here the shape of the wings, right? So the top of the wing is curved. The scientific name for a wing is actually an airfoil. So the top of it is curved like this, so it's thicker here at the front and thinner at the back, while the bottom of the wing is flat. You see that? So what happens when air passes over the wing is this. The curve of the wing causes the air that's over the top of it to thin out and it becomes less dense. And so what happens is the air on the bottom doesn't change. It stays thick and heavy. And so what happens is as the airplane goes faster and faster, the air on top of the wing gets thinner and thinner, so there's less and less pressure while the pressure on the bottom builds. And what that does is once the plane's going fast enough, it takes off, it lifts. That's what we call that. That's called lift, and that's what gets the plane in the air. And that's why big planes can fly. All they need is a wing shape. They need the wing to be shaped correctly and to be big enough, and the plane has to be able to fly fast enough to change the air pressure enough to create lift. Now today is Pentecost Sunday. This is the day when we celebrate the coming of the Holy Spirit. So remember in our stories, after Jesus ascends into heaven, he tells the disciples to wait in Jerusalem, and a gift is coming from God. So this is in the book of Acts, chapter 2, and the disciples are all gathered together in a house in Jerusalem, and they are waiting just as Jesus asked them to. And all of a sudden, they hear a mighty rushing wind coming towards them, and little tongues of flame appear above their heads, and they are filled with the Holy Spirit. And suddenly, they could speak all sorts of languages, different languages they'd never been able to speak before. But this was really important because they needed this gift to be able to take the good news of the gospel out to all the nations of the world and share the word as Jesus had asked them to do. Now, the Holy Spirit is God's gift to us. It lives in us to comfort us and to guide us so that we can live as Jesus taught us and to do the work that he wants us to do. The Holy Spirit helps to lift us so that we can be the hands and feet of Jesus in the world. And that's a wonderful thing, isn't it? So think about this week and how you can be the hands and feet of Jesus and how the Holy Spirit can lift you up to do that work. Have a good week, everyone. Take good care. Wash your hands, wear your masks, and we'll see you next time. God bless everyone. Bye.